the entire time, over 2 days, amazingly, I didn't hear not only a single anti-Semitic comment, but not even a passing anti-Zionist comment that I would have fully expected somebody to have uttered. I heard plenty of criticisms of the Palestinian leadership from the Gulf leaders themselves, and which was publicly amazing. I went over quite cautiously. Of course, I had come across quite a bit of criticism of the event, with people missing at the table. Is this an event worth happening? And critical people at the table, such as Hamas, naturally, and the Palestinian Authority, and any Israeli political officials. How in the world could this make progress? And I realized how wrong-headed that thinking was. And sadly, much of the U.S. press was still caught up in a time warp, not understanding what in fact happened, that the old cliche of how absence makes the heart grow fonder, and in fact the absence of those warring parties made for an incredible dialogue to imagine what the end state could be.
It just sounds to me like people were saying, oh, we would invest tens of billions of dollars, it'll be great if you're wise enough to sign a peace accord. But how does that move us toward a peace accord?
Well, I'm glad you used the term invest, because there are an awful lot of people, well-intended people, not only heroic figures in Israel and devoted nationalists in Palestine, but a gigantic public affairs, international lobbying establishment in Washington and in global authorities that are perhaps unconsciously vested in the status quo. Having them not there gave an opportunity for breakthrough to imagine what could be. It was a really exciting plan in a way where they looked like in 10 years could dramatically, perhaps even double GDP of Palestine, of taking a look at cutting unemployment from beyond 30% to almost single digits, taking a look at reducing the poverty rate by at least half.
I have no doubt that if there were peace between Israel and the Palestinians, maybe a state of Palestine, there'd be plenty of investments, and sure, building highways and desalination plants would be routine. But that seems to ignore the fact that there isn't peace. So maybe Bahrain, as much as you admired it, maybe it was a waste of time. Didn't Jared Kushner admit that if there is no peace, if his political vision is not embraced, we might as well forget about everything you saw?
This is a time for fluidity, a time to think differently. That's what's needed here on all sides. And to imagine what peace could mean, what a thriving, successful economic region could be. And that's what the success of this conference was, is to model what could be and to hear from major Arab leaders from around the region saying, we're ready to make this happen. We're ready to make this come to life. And here's a very tangible way where this can happen. If we can get past the self-interest of Palestinian leaders and some Israeli leaders that are harboring divisive dreams.
And therefore, the Palestinians might give up their ambition for an independent Palestinian state?
I didn't hear anybody rule out the possibility of a Palestinian state that never came up in the discussions. This was an economic plan, not a political plan. That was everybody's agreement coming in there, is how can we have infrastructure work together, that we are have a tremendous shortage of programmers in Israel. Why keep importing Ukrainians when you have highly educated, unemployed Palestinians footsteps away? How can we make that happen better? And I know there'll be plenty of people watching who said, well, in the past, there was more fluidity in the labor force, and lots of reasons why the barriers had to be created for security. Is now taking a look at how can we make that work better? And yes, but I nothing was ruled out in terms of there being a two-state solution. Or these populations have far more in common than they do have that divides them. And an economic plan is something that brings to the realization what a thriving center this can be of agriculture, of advanced manufacturing, of tourism, of so much that can be done together. And I walk out very optimistic and very enthusiastic. And again, remember, Dan, I went over there quite skeptically about taking this on as to if it made sense. And that isn't the way I walk away.